And there was Mary in Iowa, sitting on the porch with Ed Revere, and the prairie night around her. Night of cicadas, the tiny voices of darkness, night of moths and the meadow smell, and the peepers singing their hearts out. Night of longing, of wind and rivers moving under the quiet stars, and the clouds passing over Iowa, over the Mississippi, high in the dome of air, over the prairies, over the corn and the wheat, over the singing. Oh, fragrant night, slow-moving arch of sleep, flowing in silence through these shadowy hours, spaced by the stars and by the gentle winds, night of the prairies faint with meadow flowers, American night, unhurried, midsummer deep. And Ed Revere, his hands horny, his thoughts slow and untidy, one single speck of life among the infinite numbers, cricket and ant, the incalculable multitudes, birds, bees and foxes, rabbits, the woolly moth, the clouds of herring, bushels full of snails, borer and beetle, octopus and eel. How many gnats can dance upon a pod? How many flies can settle on a rind? How many mites a dinner for the lark? Ed looked at Mary and he felt his heart lean like a heavy weight against his ribs. So much was youth and so much was the dark. So much was Edward and the rest was God. Who makes a female lovely to her kind and to all others a mystery or a meal? Ed couldn't marry for he had no money. His home was under the roof of Anderson's barn or wherever he happened to be, scattering feed to Kansas chickens, or up in Minnesota helping to plant the wheat or mind a dairy. He had no land of his own to put a house on. He had no house of his own to offer Mary. He was American as mustard seed, but his bed was a wooden floor and a bundle of hay. He gave what he had, the good green gift of his hands, but he had no heart to say what he had to say. My mother grew up in an Ozark clearing. She hated hills, she was nature-fearing. She had one wish, to see a city. She met my father, he thought her pretty. And before my mother was 9 months older, I was born with a mountain over my shoulder. My father was poor, he counted his pennies. He died in a storm in the Alleghenies. It grieved her heart, she had asked for little. She brought me up, but her health was brittle. She gave her strength to whatever might need her. I buried her under a mountain cedar. She slumbers now where my father found her. I left her there with the hills around her. I aim to study the world or near it, to find a woman to rest my spirit. But what he said was different. They sat together, the night was around them both, and they watched the night. They talked of the tasseled corn and the growing weather, and what if it came to rain and whether it might, and how to use a hay that was too much clover, and what to plant in fields that were too much sand. They sat apart. The darkness covered them over. He twisted his empty hat around in his hands.